Krishna, dear friends. Happy Balram Jayanti. On the auspicious occasion of Balram Jayanti, today we will be discussing some of his extraordinary pastimes. Lord Balram is lovingly called as Dahu, meaning an elder brother. He is an elder brother of Lord Krishna. Shri Baldev is the Supreme Personality of Godhead himself. In Treta Yuga, Baldevji appears as Lakshman. In Kali Yuga, he appears as Lord Nityananda. He is the original Adi Guru. All the spiritual strength, knowledge comes from him. The Balram feature is as good as Krishna himself. The only difference being that the bodily hue of Krishna is dark and that of Balram is fair. So what does this name Balram means? What is the meaning of the word Balram? It is stated in Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran, Canto 10, Chapter 8, Text 12. When King Nanda, the father of Krishna and Balram in Gokula, called Gargamuni for the name-giving ceremony or Namakaran Samskar, Gargamuni gives this explanation. He says, because the son of Rohini increases the transcendental bliss of others, his name is Ram, and because his extraordinary strength, he is called Baldeva. So Balram is the one who provides all the transcendental bliss and the one who is the most powerful. So the appearance day or birthday of dear Dauji is approaching soon. So let's contemplate on his most wonderful and beautiful glorious pastimes, which will reflect some of the millions of nectarian qualities of the one who provides the ultimate bliss. Pastime 1, killing of Dhenukasur. Dhenukasur was a powerful demon who had assumed the form of an ass. With his demon friends, he was occupying Talvan, one of the 12 forests of Vrindavan. Out of fear of this demon, no one could approach Talvan and enjoy the numerous flowers and fruits in the forest. Balaram, induced by his cowherd friends, entered the forest desiring to kill the demons. He began shaking the fruit trees, making a big noise. Dhenuka, ferocious intrusion, attacked Balram with his rear legs, but Balram easily picked him up by his legs and whirled him around until he died. As the other demon friends of Dhenuka rushed to attack, Krishna and Balram picked them up and threw them on the trees, killing them. Soon the forest was free of all demons, and it appeared that the bent trees were being directed by Balram to pay obeisances to Krishna. Pastime 2, killing of Pralambasur. Once when Krishna and Balram were playing with the cowherd boys, a demon named Pralamba entered their midst disguised as a cowherd boy. Understanding the invincible potency of Krishna, he instead decided to abduct Balram. At the end of the game, as the losing party, he was supposed to carry Balram on his shoulders. Carrying the Lord on his shoulder, he ran swiftly. But Balram, realizing the true identity of demon, began to make himself heavier and heavier. Unable to bear the weight, the demon assumed his original form, which was like a huge dark effulgent cloud decorated with golden ornaments. Balram then brought his fist down the head of the demon, splitting it into two and causing him to give up his life. Balram was glorified by Krishna and his other friends. Pastime 3, love and reciprocation between dear brothers. As the elder brother of Krishna, Balram was the object of his love and respect. Once, when walking in the forest of Vrindavan, Krishna observed the trees bending down as if paying obeisances. He glorified the lotus feet of Balram as being the object of devotion even for the demigods. He said that the trees, which were impersonalist in the previous lifetimes, witnessing the personal form of Balaram, were now praying for his devotion. At other times, when Balram would get tired by playing, he would lie down on the lap of one of the cowherd boys, and Krishna would personally massage his feet, fan him, and give him service. Such was the sweet reciprocation of love between Krishna and Balram. Pastime 4. Balram marries Revati. In Satyuga, there was a king named Revat, whose daughter Revati was excellent in all respects. Unable to find a match suitable for her, the king took her to the court of Brahma for his advice. After waiting for some time, when the king met with Brahma, he was shocked to learn that in the short time he spent in the Brahmaloka, millions of years had already passed on earth, and at the time Dwapara Yuga was concluding. However, Lord Brahma informed King Revat that present at this time was Lord Balram, who was more than qualified to be the husband of Revati. King Revat returned and approached Balram to accept Revati as his wife. However, Revati belonged to an earlier Yuga when people were much larger physically. So Lord Balram placed his plow on her head until she shrunk to an appropriate size and accepted her as his wife. Pastime 5. Killing of Ramaharshan. Towards the end of Dwapara Yuga, thousands of sages assembled on the banks of Naimisharanya to perform a 1,000-year yagya in an effort to reverse the onset of Kali Yuga. They appointed as their leader Ramaharshan, one of the main disciples of Vyasadev, who was also present when Shukadev Goswami narrated Srimad Bhagavatam to King Parikshit. When Lord Balram entered the assembly, understanding him to be the Supreme Personality of Godhead, all present rose to offer him respect. However, Ramaharshan, proud at occupying the position of the leader, did not get up. Lord Balram could understand that even though Ramaharshan was an expert Vedantist, he had not yet realized these teachings. Considering him unqualified to lead this ceremony, Balram touched him with a blade of grass, causing him to die. He then instituted Suta, the son of Ramaharshan, as the leader of the assembly and continued with his pilgrimage. This land of Vrindavan is glorified today because Lord Balram's lotus feet have touched her earth and grass. Your fingernails have touched her trees and creepers, and your merciful eyes have glanced upon her rivers, hills, birds, and beasts. When Balram embraced his brother in a playful mood of ecstasy, Krishna looked like a blue jewel held within a conch shell. Seeing the mixture of their brilliant effulgences, Yashoda could not tell them apart. Srila Prabhupada writes, Lord Balram is the original Vishnu. Therefore, anyone remembering these pastimes of Lord Balaram in the morning and evening will suddenly become a great devotee of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and thus his life will become successful in all the respects.